All right, YouTube, we're here at Tom's shop. Hey,
there
Tom.
Again,
we're back. Who's up back there with you?
No. Shorty.
Shorty. Shorty. That ain't Shorty, that's Mitchell Cartledge. Hey, Mitch.
Hey,
Al. Oh, Sarge.
He's doing a toothpick.
A toothpick.
Yeah, look here.
We'll definitely look at that.
Look at this toothpick he's doing.
Don't know if this camera will be able to pick up the detail on that, folks, but trust me, there's a little bitty feller in there, and he is too cool.
I believe he's a fireman.
Yep, he's a fireman. I can see it. I don't know whether this camera's going to pick up on it or not. We'll zoom in. It gets a little too close. So this
That's
is
what
the
they call editing.
Editing. Yeah. We'll definitely do a lot of that. So this is a class that Tom and Gary puts on annually. And this has been going on for how long, Tom?
I don't know. 3, 4, 5 years.
Right.
Since Harold retired.
Right. Harold Enlow used to do the class. So we got some folks over here working and carving, looks like anything from Santa Claus, cowboys, and whatever they've worked on with Tom during the week. So I'm just going to be kind of panning around, looking at some of, we got Gary's artwork in here, and of course we got Tom's stuff. It's art. Now, all right, Tom, what you got here with horns coming out of its head?
That's a Viking.
It's a Viking. I didn't know. I all got
well.
It. There we go. Yep, I can tell them here. I didn't know whether you was doing another one of your evil guys that you do that runs the wood spirits off. That's good. I like it. All right, see, Gary's got a few of his pieces sitting there.
Yeah,
got them up there for me to knock off.
Right.
I can knock him off 2 or 3 different ways, you know. I can copy him and knock him off that way, you know.
Shoot, we all work off each one another anyway, I reckon.
Yeah.
I noticed that there's a little thing on this. This is, I believe, a rough out. But
that's what Lee Duke said, so we all copy from each other.
That's right. Mr. Lee Duke, Charlotte. Yeah, we got a bunch of pieces right
these
around.
These down front here are Gary's.
Okay.
And the things in the shelves back in there's mine.
All right. Let me kind of get in here on. Man, there's a pile of them. Got wizards. Wizards with cowboy hats.
Let me show you his snake hat band. Got a rattlesnake hat band on this guy.
Hey, now, that is just too cool.
He even got a pin to hold his hat back. See?
Look at that. Now, folks from Appalachia would probably know what this is, and out west probably use this a time or two, wouldn't you reckon, Tom?
Yeah, I imagine.
All right. That's neat.
That's cool.
Gary might learn to carve one of these days.
I'd say if he keeps at it, I believe he'll make a carver yet.
Right. Excellent stuff.
Here's another one I like back here real well. I believe he said he did this from one of Harold's.
Yep. Oh, look at there. Got his foot stuck in some
bubble gum. Double bubble.
Double bubble. That's one thing about it, folks. Backer won't do that.
Right. It just sticks to your shoe.
That's it. That is neat. I believe I seen that old boy last weekend there.
Yeah. I've been to a couple places that he played at.
Where is Gary? He just stepped outside.
He went outside to take care of his nasty habit of smoking.
Oh yeah. We all got our vices, I reckon. All right, I'm sneaking in the back door trying to find look, there he is. There's who? Gary Falin. Falin?
Falin, that's it.
Now, I just want to do that for the record. I know this is Mr. Gary Falin from Alcoa, Tennessee. Like to start off with just saying that Gary travels and does a lot of classes. These are some of his pieces. And how long you been carving there, Gary? That's
My mother tells me that I started when I was 3 years old.
Hey.
On the arm of a rocking chair with a butcher knife.
Well, see, we all got our start somewhere, and that's one of the things that I'm always asked, and probably the second thing, and I'm sure you hear it too, is that knife sharp? You ever heard that one?
Not many times.
Not many times. I've heard it quite a few. I always have to scratch my head and try not to be real smart, but I do know that you travel extensively throughout for folks that want you here and there, so we'll post your phone number up. That is your preferred method of being contacted, correct?
Correct.
All right. We'll do that up on this YouTube thing. But what did y'all start carving on this weekend?
Oh, we've been carving Santa Clauses, cowboys, and football players.
All right. If I get you to...
Some of them that we do. And when I do a class, I just let you pick what you want to carve.
All right. If you wouldn't mind picking up, because I don't want to pick up your artwork there, if you just pick one up, and that way I can kind of zoom in on it, one of maybe your favorite pieces.
Here's my newest cowboy.
Newest cowboy. Got a rough out on him?
I got a rough out on him. His name is Chapstick.
All right. So anybody wants a rough out of old Chapstick? And where'd you get that name Chapstick, I wonder? Good. Those of you that know Gary know he's got an awesome sense of humor. So that's it, and it shows coming out in the carving. So just kind of wanted to spend a little bit of time, let him show some of his art here. That's neat.
This guy's name is Possum Bill.
Nice hat.
Well, don't wear it live.
you gotta cure them out, don't you?
Yep.
All right, Mr. Gary, we sure do appreciate
it.
So you gonna be doing this again next year with Tom?
I'm not
good
sure.
Lord's willing, and the creeks don't rise.
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
Well, we sure do appreciate it, Gary.
All right, thank you.
What's that, Gary?
I said those are nice walkers.
Thank you.
I love that big nose.
Thank you, sir. Always figured out if you put a big nose on one, that's less of a face you got to carve.
Yeah, true.
Some of Tom's walking sticks. Yeah.